Black holes are a region of space that have such an intense gravitational field that no light or matter can escape them. We know that supermassive black holes are at the center of almost every galaxy. These supermassive black holes are humongous. They are millions or even billions of times the size of our sun. But what would happen if a black hole hit another black hole? That's the question we are asking today on Life's Biggest Questions. Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that asks the fundamental questions of life. I'm Charlotte Dobre, and on this channel we answer a question every single day. Topics range from science and scary movies to politics and history. If that sounds like something you're into, subscribe and join the notification squad. What happens when two gigantic space vacuums smash into each other? It's a fair question considering the fact that there are actually quite a lot of black holes in the universe. There are an estimated 100 million black holes in the Milky Way galaxy alone. There are actually so many black holes in the universe that it would be impossible to even count them, which is why it's entirely possible that one black hole could hit another. And in fact, it happens a lot more often than you'd think. If a black hole collided with another black hole, the bigger one probably wouldn't eat the smaller one. Well, not exactly. They also wouldn't bounce off each other and carry on their black hole way. Once they become trapped by each other's gravity, a huge cosmic event is underway. There's actually a name for that cosmic event. It's called a binary black hole. A binary black hole is when two black holes are in close orbit around each other. For a very long time, it was difficult to prove that binary black holes even existed, and that was largely to do with the fact that the instruments to detect them were not advanced enough. We simply just couldn't see them with traditional telescopes. But during the 20th and 21st centuries, the scientific community became very interested in binary black holes because proving binary black holes existed meant proving gravitational waves existed. Gravitational waves were predicted by Einstein's theory of general relativity. Detecting gravitational waves meant proving that they exist, and therefore would help us get a better understanding of how gravity really works. When two black holes get so close that they can't escape each other's gravity, they would eventually collide and merge to become one big black hole. When this happens, it undoubtedly releases an immense amount of energy, so intense that ripples are sent through the fabric of space-time across the universe. The gravity exerted by a black hole is so immense on its own, but two black holes? Smashing into one another? Well, that's another story. These ripples are called gravitational waves, and when black holes collide, they shoot out across the universe at the speed of light. In recent years, instruments capable of detecting gravitational waves from outer space have been constructed, like the Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory, aka LIGO, which was completed in 2002. Then, on the 14th of September 2016, a merger of two black holes was detected by LIGO. The readings showed up as spikes. Astrophysicists had finally recorded two black holes colliding for the very first time, proving that gravitational waves exist. And also for the very first time, astronauts have recently observed two black holes getting closer together and then colliding. It's extremely hard for us to observe one black hole hitting another because there's so much dust swirling around the galaxies, obscuring their view from Earth. When black holes collide, it's a very violent occurrence. Matter and dust is thrown around, and a thick curtain of material forms around the collision so that the nuclei of the black holes can't be seen with conventional telescopes. Until now, it was not possible to observe two black holes colliding. But using X-ray data from the Burst Alert Telescope, as well as laser capability of the Keck Observatory, scientists created infrared imagery of two black holes colliding. According to a survey of 500 galaxies, many galaxies actually have two merging black holes at their centers. This is because when galaxies merge, so too do their black holes. This is because when galaxies merge, so too do their supermassive black holes. It's an extremely long process. It takes billions of years to happen, but it ends very quickly. The black hole at the center of our galaxy, the Milky Way, and the closest galaxy to us, Andromeda, will collide in a few billion years' time. Right now, we're moving toward Andromeda at a speed of 250,000 miles per hour. In a few billion years, there won't be two separate galaxies anymore. They will be one super galaxy. In fact, one of the reasons why supermassive black holes exist in the first place is likely because they were once smaller black holes that merged, and so too did their galaxies. Don't you just love space? We still don't know a whole lot about black holes or what happens when they collide. But hopefully this video has provided some insight into what happens when one black hole hits another. For now, I'm Charlotte Dobre, and you've been watching Life's Biggest Questions. To go on an LBQ binge, check out the playlist that's clickable on your screen right now. And make sure notifications are turned on by clicking the bell icon so we can see you in a future episode of Life's Biggest Questions.